Good evening, everyone.
Buenas tardes a todo
So
el mundo.
today is
Hoy es
Tuesday,
martes,
June 18th.
junio 18.
This is the regular meeting of the, or no, this is a special meeting of the joint
Y esta es una reunión especial de la escuela,
and
donde
city council.
Y el comité de la ciudad.
And we are being recorded right now. The meeting
grabados.
Is live on public access.
La reunión está
the
en vivo
meeting
en
is
acceso
being
público.
Live streamed through the city's Boxcast on the
y
website. And so before we get started, I'll ask everyone to please rise for
favor,
the Pledge of Allegiance.
Juro a la bandera de Estados Unidos y a la República, la cual es separa en, que es una nación debajo de Dios individual y con justicia
Thank
para
you,
todos.
Everyone.
Gracias a todo el mundo.
So the clerk will call
Así
the roll,
que la secretaria va a llamar
will,
las reglas.
Explain
y yo
why
voy
we're
a
here tonight
explicar por qué
and what we're
aquí,
doing
y
and
qué
how it's
estamos
gonna
haciendo
go.
Y cómo va a salir.
Anderson Burgos.
Anderson Burgos.
Here.
Aquí.
Bartley.
Bartley. Aquí.
Here. Divine.
Divine.
Givner.
Aquí. Givner.
Grainy.
Grainy.
Here.
Aquí.
Jordan.
Jordan.
Here.
Aquí.
McGrath Smith.
McGrath Smith.
Here.
Aquí.
Murphy Rumbeletti.
Murphy Rumbeletti.
Here. Ocasio.
Ocasio.
Yeah.
Israel Rivera.
Israel Rivera. Aquí.
Jenny Rivera.
Jenny Rivera.
Here.
Aquí.
Sullivan.
Sullivan. Aquí.
Bacon.
Bacon.
Here.
Aquí.
Cavaro Rocco.
Cavaro Rocco.
Collimore.
Collimore.
Garcia.
Garcia. Okay.
Right there.
Yep.
Yo, Mike.
Here.
Okay.
Lefebvre.
Dave.
Oh, here.
Okay.
Rivera Colon.
Rivera Colon.
Here.
Okay.
Romero.
Romero.
Yeah.
Okay.
Tinsley Williams.
Present.
William, presenting.
Willahan.
Willahan.
Okay. Wilson.
Wilson.
Here.
Here.
And one more item of housekeeping, Councillor
Jardine
is on Zoom, so I would entertain a motion to take a roll call vote that for the purposes, oh, Councillor Givner's here, that for the purposes of this meeting would be applicable to all motions to remove an item from the table, place items on the table, package items, open or close a public hearing, or suspend the rules unless there is an objection. Motion was made and seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
¿Alguien se opone?
So moved.
Así que nos movamos.
So,
así que,
this is
este
a meeting. The purpose of this meeting tonight is for both the school committee and the city council to appoint a member to fill the vacant at-large school committee seat.
De la escuela,
and
de la silla, de la
I am joined up here on the podium this evening by our esteemed vice chair, Mildred Lefebvre. And I would entertain a motion to suspend the rules to allow Mildred to help facilitate.
Second.
All those in favor? Any opposed? So moved. Thank you. Basically, the purpose of this evening, we have a lot of really awesome candidates who have submitted their resumes. There may be folks here tonight in the audience that might not have submitted a resume, and they're also welcome to submit their name this evening. But we do have a stack of resumes here, and so the purpose is to, the way we're going to do it and the way we did it last time when we appointed Dr. Rivera Colon to fill the vacant Ward 3 seat. Every candidate, you have the opportunity, 3 to 5 minutes, just introduce yourselves, and you know, why you're here, and we can open it up for questions, and Mildred is, or Councillor, school committee member, Lefebvre is going to help field the questions from school committee members. I will help with city councilors, and you know, we encourage everyone, if you are choosing to ask questions, that's awesome. We encourage you to, you know, ask everyone those questions, you know, just for the sake of fairness. And you know, before we even get started, I want to thank any person who put their name in. Thank you for doing this. I hope that no matter what happens, you'll consider public office, public service. We appreciate you
oficina,
just putting your name in. It really takes a lot
pública,
of bravery and commitment into our city, and so we're very thankful for everyone who put their name in, no matter what happens. And for the purposes of this evening, tonight there
noche,
are, so we have 13 city councilors, we have 10 school committee members, Miembro del, bueno, so the first person to get to 12 votes this evening is the person who will fill the vacant seat. And the clerk will be calling the roll. And we'll go from there. And we'll go as many times as we need to until someone gets to 12 votes. Are there any questions or concerns? Seeing no further discussion.
Como veo que no hay discusión.
Yes. So, sí. do you want to mention that?
¿Quieres mencionar eso?
So real quickly and just to clarify.
Aunque sí, muy rápido para clarificar.
So although the position is a 4-year position,
es una posición de 4 años.
According to our charter and our policies, it will only be to serve through December 31st, 2025.
And then
whoever runs for the seat in the special election at the next municipal will then serve the remaining 2 years.
Entonces puede correr los otros 2 años.
Thank you. So I'm going based off the stack of resumes that I've got in front of me. And that's just the order that we'll go in.
El montón de hojas de vida que tengo aquí.
First up,
la primera,
Kyle Chambers.
Kyle Chamber.
And Kyle, if you'd like, there's an open
Kyle,
seat here, so if you do want to sit,
si
and, or if you prefer to stand,
si
you totally can stand at the microphone,
estar,
whatever you want. Just make sure that green button is on. If it's lit up, that means your microphone is on.
Si
and you want to make sure that you're speaking, this goes for everyone, but speak directly into the microphone so that everyone can at home
para
can
que
hear you.
En casa te puede escuchar.
Okay, everybody can hear
okay,
me, right?
Todo el mundo me puede
good?
Escuchar.
Okay,
estamos
cool.
Bien, chévere.
So, good evening, everyone.
Así que buenas tardes a todo
el
mundo.
Mi
nombre es Kyle Chambers.
I am a veteran.
Yo soy un veterano.
I served in the Marine Corps from 2011 to 2015.
En la Marina.
I served the community as a 911 dispatcher
Y actualmente estoy sirviendo como
a clerk in the registrar's
un secretario en nuestra oficina de registración. Yo he estado haciendo ese trabajo por 2 años. Y es mi llamado. Y absolutamente me encanta la posición en que me gusta.
I am a parent.
Yo soy un padre.
A kindergartner, soon to be
una persona de un niño de en kindergarten
and I'm so excited
y
to
estoy
be
muy,
here tonight,
muy emocionado
as,
de estar acá
parent,
como padre
who
quien
believes in
cree
what the city
en lo que
doing.
La ciudad está haciendo
I did have three
yo
key
sí tuve claves iniciales en las cuales le quise hablar sobre
these are kind of things that I really wanted to focus on
our
post receivership education
nuestro hacer planes de educación
it's a,
obviamente
it's a big deal
es
that,
un gran
DESE has finally allowed the Holyoke schools
la cual que
a way out
permite
of
una manera de
and so
de salir de este enlace.
I would like to
así que me gustaría
as a parent,
como padre
kind of look at what the state has given
que
us
lo que el estado
nos ha dado nosotros
durante los
9
años
what
y
works.
Darnos
there's
cuenta
a lot of
que,
things
que
do,
trabaja hay muchas cosas que trabajan
the dual language model
y
that was introduced
el tema de dual lenguajes en los
I think is
tremendous.
You know what doesn't work.
Y lo que, ¿qué es lo que no trabajo?
Many would say the block scheduling for
diría,
third graders as a PTO member.
Los miembros de los horarios de
that's probably
de
something that needs to be
de los niños de tercer grado y como miembro de eso.
Second off,
que hacer. Y segundo,
I
me gustaría dirigir
mental health support.
El apoyo de estado mental.
I remember watching a
me acuerdo viendo
meeting,
un comité de la escuela
not too long ago,
no hace mucho.
The school representative for dean mentioned that the resources that our students have are insufficient.
Son insuficientes.
We are in 2024, so we're after the pandemic.
Y después de la pandemia,
you know, our country is
nuestro
different.
Diferente,
things have changed
diferente.
So
Mucha
much.
Bastante.
And we are facing a mental health crisis in our schools.
Un crisis de salud mental.
And while I did watch the budget meeting from the superintendent a couple weeks ago, and I do say there are things that address a lot of the issues that we have. I think we still have a long way to go,
y creo que tenemos bastante
and I think it's important that we evaluate
que
where the biggest need is, and those of us parents that are truly involved really want to
nosotros
help
realmente podemos ayudar con eso.
In March,
en marzo,
myself and a couple of other members of our PTO,
y otro miembro
some of whom
de PTO,
I know pretty well,
mucha gente que,
we ended up meeting the school
nosotros,
committee
and
had a very productive conversation about things
el
like recess
de la escuela,
and
bastante,
lunch
and
how important
receso,
that social
la
piece of education
y como,
is.
Qué tan importante es.
And I think
Eso.
It was very, it was very impressive to me because I felt like we were actually being heard as parents. So the last thing I want to focus on is educator support and retention. We have a young workforce of educators. I remember going to school at Ian White and seeing one set of teachers, and then years later, you know, I don't see any of those teachers anymore, which tells me there's a lot of younger educators that work for the city. It takes some special skills to work in the city of Holyoke as an educator. And I think we need to kind of focus on what it takes to retain those educators and incentivize staying, because if they work here for 5 years and then they leave, we have to start over again. And how much resources are we wasting in allowing that to happen? So,
así que,
yeah, that's basically
eso es básicamente lo que yo tengo. Yo no sé cuánto tiempo tenga.
Just about under, it's just under 5.
So. Está okay. Debajo de 5.
Perfect.
Gracias. So,
that's me.
Ese soy yo. Gracias.
Thank you. Thank you. Any questions?
¿Alguna pregunta?
Miss Wilson.
Señor Wilson.
So you spoke about initiatives involving money
dinero.
With our financial situation, and we are in a very good state
estamos
here
buen
with our
aquí,
schools.
Con
where
escuelas?
Would you find those funds in order to,
para,
you know, incentivize retention,
retención,
as well as
en cuanto a
work more with
trabajar más con
mental health and issues.
Con,
yeah, that's a great
mentales.
Question. I mean,
I'm
not immune to the idea
that
we
idea.
Get something like, what, only 12% of the school budget comes from
del presupuesto
taxes,
de la escuela viene de
less than 12%,
menos del 12%,
and the rest comes
y el resto
from
viene
the Student Opportunity Act.
De
so I know there is additional
funds,
the state recently approved through a vote additional funding for the fair
para,
yeah, okay. I'll remember it later.
Yo me acuerdo
so there's additional funding there that I think we can definitely take a look at, but also, and I haven't
pero
gone
no,
through the budget with a fine-tooth comb, but I know there's got to be, there's got to be creative ways that we as parents, as educators, and as administrators can find redundancies and find places where we can find money. I mean, as PTO members, because I started serving on the NY PTO, we're working on trying to raise funds to support the Ian White School. I know there's a citywide PTO that's also starting to stand up that's really trying to do the same thing.
And
so, like, I think, you know, as parents, like, we're going to try and find ways to fund some of these things.
Para buscar fondos de esta manera.
Other questions?
Otras preguntas.
Did you, Councilor Rivera?
Councilor Rivera.
I just have a comment.
Realmente tengo un comentario.
I say thank you first of all.
Gracias.
It takes a lot to
come bastante para venir aquí y sentirte y ponerte allá afuera.
But one of the things I kind of wanted to see just
quiero ver
more,
un poquito más
one
que
initiatives
una
de las
iniciativas que organizaste.
Said you were proud of
que dijiste que está muy orgulloso.
Cover letter was around the MCAS.
Sobre el MCAS.
See if you can expand
para ver que si puedes expandir.
Yeah, absolutely.
To hear more about
solamente para escuchar sobre el tema de
yeah, so I worked with teachers within Holyoke to collect signatures
para
to put the question on the ballot, which would, if successful, eliminate the punitive graduation requirement.
La,
of the MCAS, which disproportionately has harmed our students, has harmed students of color, students in low-income households where they may be food or shelter insecure. You know, what are these students supposed to do after they've gone through high school, after we have collectively said, you know what, you're good to go, you should be graduating, but the state says no because you didn't pass a test that maybe or maybe maybe not you didn't understand. So I was really fired up to start collecting signatures. I worked with people in Hamden County. Hamden County was a big source of people who were interested in this. I walked around UMass Amherst, where I live, took a lunch break, collected signatures, talked to students who were voters in the state of Massachusetts, who absolutely saw this as like our chance to do something right. I mean, we are one, in Massachusetts, we are one of 12 states that has a graduation requirement that's tied to a test. Well, I guarantee you, if you have a child that is thinking more about where their next meal is going to come from, that's setting them up for failure, you know? And I'd be interested to see how many students in the city of Holyoke have been hurt by this, because we have really good initiatives like the opportunity,
the
Opportunity Academy,
de la Academia de Oportunidad,
that flies contradictory to that. How are we serving our students as educators if they're going to be let down by a test, by an arbitrary test made by people who did not write a test for them? You know, that's just the thing about Holyoke is a unique community with unique issues, but a unique population.
Our problems are not going to be solved
by cookie-cutter answers from edupreneurs. They're going to have to come from within our community. We collectively have to figure out how to make our kids succeed when they are competing with students from all around Western Massachusetts who are in schools that are much better funded than ours.
Con escuelas que tienen mejores fondos que nosotros.
Ms. Tensley Williams.
Señor Williams.
Nice to see you, Mr. Chambers.
Bueno verte, señor Chambers.
What's the age of your child that's going to eat in White?
So he is 6 years old.
¿Cuál es la edad del niño que va a llevar?
You mentioned that.
Así que mencionaste de que conociste con los padres.
Were there a lot of problems?
Y había muchos problemas con los padres cuando te hablaron sobre receso.
Yeah, that's a great question. So.
Sí, es una buena pregunta.
When my wife and I first started joining the PTO meetings, there were a lot of parents who were concerned that recess was being withheld from students who were having behavioral issues,
which
seems kind of counterintuitive if you think about it, because a lot of those students have pent-up energy and they need to get it out. And we also advocated for more time at lunch because a lot of students were not getting the nutrition they needed to sustain themselves. And so that was definitely something that we heard early on. I haven't heard so much about it recently. I don't know if it's just a matter of people said it so many times that what's the point, or you know, but it's definitely still an issue.
We
did have a response from the superintendent who was looking at extending recess for students. You know, but I will always advocate for my students, for my son, and for the students that he goes to school with, and all the students in the city.
Thank you, sir.
Así que gracias.
Thank you. Councilor Graney?
Councilor Graney?
Yes, thank you, Mr. Chambers.
Gracias, señor.
What requirements would you have for graduation?
¿Qué requerimiento va a pedir para,
I think the graduation, I don't know exactly what the graduation requirements are in the city beyond passing the current curriculum. I'm more just focused on eliminating the MCAS graduation requirements, simply because, again, it doesn't factor in it doesn't factor in students that may not understand the test.
I actually
had a conversation with a coworker about this recently, and she said, well, when we had students who didn't understand and they were in special education, they had somebody that was there to kind of guide them through it.
para que lo guíe.
You know, what happens when we don't have those things in place?
You know,
I'm okay with what we have at the moment, and I'm absolutely okay with reevaluating what we have.
Que evaluando con lo que tenemos.
But I'm firmly against the MCAS being used as a measure. I know we're not going to get rid of the MCAS.
Yo sé que no,
it's a federal requirement.
Es una petición
federal. It's here to stay, and it does collect a lot of data. We are a very data-driven society.
Nosotros
but what happens when we have that data?
¿Qué pasa cuando tenemos esa data que estamos haciendo?
So
I understand the.
Así que mi entendimiento es que,
for instance,
por instancia, el MCAS, si pregunta, le pregunte a un
estudiante
que cómo se ve el mar, y esa persona nunca ha ido al mar. Entonces, definitivamente, esa persona está correcta. Entonces, va a estar equivocada en el MCAS. Así que necesitamos un sistema que esté medido, ¿verdad?
Into the workspace and into the world out there, which is a very competitive, big, bad world. So, once again, what requirement would you
have? ¿Qué requerimiento vas a pedir para que nuestros estudiantes se gradúen de high school?
Do we...
Presently, there are some
porque eventualmente
out there
hay niños allá afuera que se están graduando sin poder leer.
Yeah, no, I think if they're able to pass
si ellos pueden pasar
standards that we are setting for them,
otherwise,
like, independent of what
como,
the test is, because even if they pass the test,
if they can't
pass our standards,
si ellos pasar
they still don't
get
a
diploma. Como quieran, no pueden conseguir un diploma.
It's absolutely necessary that they pass the they pass the standards
de que pasen
that we
los estándares
set.
Que nosotros
and I would be happy to,
así que
to
yo
reevaluate that
estaría contento de reevaluar
if we find that we
si nosotros encontramos
need
que nosotros
to
necesitamos
reevaluate
reevaluar
what we have.
Lo que tengamos.
But I think
pero yo
if
creo
we take
que
this
si nosotros
test
tomamos ese examen,
we can have that
nosotros
say
podemos
and
tener
say, you know what, this student needs
este
more education,
necesita
this, or these students are
más educación,
absolutely
o sea,
able to
esa ciudad
uniformity? What uniformity would there be?
Puede ser exitoso. Y
uniformity
mi
uniformidad
en
so
el sistema no con otras, no tanto como
because,
otras escuelas.
Again,
así porque de nuevo, nosotros tenemos
we
una población
who are over
única.
From
ahí tenemos estudiantes
like
que vienen de Puerto Rico
maybe
que tal vez
never, I mean, maybe have never spoken English before, and they're learning it for the first time.
Por primera vez.
You know, how do you assess the value of
el valor de una persona,
how do you assess
de
their intelligence?
¿Cómo asiste su inteligencia?
The science says
la
that it takes more than a test
un examen para hacer eso.
And so if
así
we can
si
come up with
salir con
a whole student-centered measure
una
of success
forma
for
de medir
student,
para estudiantes.
I think that is where
yo creo que eso
we'll
es donde
find
nosotros vamos
that
encontrar.
We that's where we'll succeed.
Eso es donde nosotros vamos a tener
oh, well and good. It was the MCAS test that caused the state to come in and take over our school system.
Creo que el MCAS tomó el examen.
Great.
El MCAS fue que hizo que el Estado tomara el control de nuestra escuela.
So I have two quick questions.
Así que yo tengo dos preguntas. Son preguntas de sí y no.
Are you going to run
for
the position once you're done with
una vez que acabes con el término?
Yes.
Sí.
And the second question
la segunda
is how are you going to do
¿cómo
in
vas
terms
a hacer
of time
en término
management?
De tiempo?
Right now, the expectation is that we have two
que nosotros
meetings
tenemos
a month,
dos reuniones al mes
with our committees,
y más
and for one,
reuniones
I meet
en la comité.
With three different subcomités
yo estoy en tres comités
there's preparation
y hay preparaciones
between,
en,
a lot of
dentro
reading,
de mucho de
in
lectura
order to come prepared for
para
meetings.
Venir preparados a las reuniones.
How is your time management
¿cómo es tu tiempo?
And in order to be able to
en tema
the,
de para
the responsibilities
llenar las responsabilidades.
That's a great question.
Es una buena pregunta.
So entonces, I use a calendar.
Yo tengo un calendario.
I literally
en
plan
cual,
out
literal,
every
yo
hour of my day. I have
cada hora
ADHD,
de mi vida. Yo tengo un tema
I,
de
like I found that that's what
control.
Works.
Y yo
and
creo
believe
que eso
me,
que
there was a lot of trial and error
ahí,
in figuring out how to do that successfully. But yeah, no, I budget my time throughout the day, figuring out
día,
what I can make time for.
Para hacer tiempos.
So I'm sorry. You said two meetings a month and then three in committee.
Comité?
I'm in particular.
Yo en particularmente, yo tengo tres, pero mayormente la gente tiene dos.
Okay.
Es su comité.
No, I mean, I have time, nights and weekends.
Así que yo tengo tiempo en la noche y fines de semana, así que absolutamente yo voy a priorizar eso.
You know, that we get somebody in this position that intends to make a difference for
their
children. Whether I get this or not, whether you agree with what I'm saying or not, I mean, I'm still going to work with my
colleagues in the PTO. We're still going to make things better for our students. Las cosas mejoran para los estudiantes, así que gracias.
Anyone else?
¿Alguien más?
Sure.
Sí.
Hopefully this is the last question.
Espero que sea la última pregunta.
So, que, like I said, I'm going to ask the question, but this is going to be everyone's same question. As a school committee continues their work to exit receivership, how will your personal and professional experience help strengthen your work?
Well, from my time as a 911 dispatcher,
I
have come to learn the community. I've seen the best in the community, and I've seen some of the most challenging aspects of what our community deals with day in and day out. As someone that works in education, I still maintain my links to how education is and how things are going.
And mis medios para
I think, and my time in the military, my regiment, stuff,
a lot of those habits, they kind of stuck with me through the years.
I feel like I bring probably the most unique set of circumstances. I grew up in the city. I went to the Holyoke schools. I graduated from the Holyoke High School class in 2006, which seems like a really long time ago upon retrospection. But I mean, I know this community. It's changed a lot.
Y cambió bastante.
I feel like así que yo siento que yo mantengo
esos lazos con la comunidad. Yo creo que
that would serve me well.
Me sirve bien.
Thank you.
Gracias.
All right.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Gracias.
We appreciate your time.
Aprecio su tiempo.
All right. Next in my stack of resumes is Joe Crescane.
Hojas de vida está Joe Crescane.
And I believe Joe is on.
Yo creo que Joe está en Zoom.
Hello.
Hola.
Hello.
So take it away, Joe.
Awesome. All right. Thank you, everybody, for having me. So it's a little serendipitous. I also actually I should apologize first of all for not being able to be there in person. I had a pre-scheduled family vacation, and any of you who have ever disappointed a four-year-old know that I probably made the right choice. So it's serendipitous. I said that because I had spent, I had three different conversations with people in my neighborhood concerning the Hoyoke public schools and their reluctance to send their students to them. And then this position popped up. You know, I just spent 3 hours of my life having those discussions. Like maybe this is worth it. My reasons for doing this. So the biggest one is similar to what Kyle had just said. I have a son who is entering pre-K at Kelly in September. So I'm going to be a Hoyoke public schools parent for the next 13 years. So to say I'm invested in this working out would be an understatement. I also am very invested in the Hoyoke education system in particular because I was an educator in the system for 8 years from 2012 to 2020. I was an English teacher at Hoyoke High School. And although I did move on to other opportunities, being truthfully honest here, there hasn't been a day that's gone by since I've missed being a part of the Hoyoke school community for all its good, for all its bad. And to me, this seems like a really great way to get back in there and do some good again. And then, the last reason I'm doing this, I've always viewed, I went into education because I view the city or town public education system as the foundation of the entire community. That might sound melodramatic, but I do really truly feel that way. I went to school in Hoyoke, Donahue de Peck to Holyoke High, and I met people from parts of the city that I wouldn't have known otherwise. I formed lifelong friendships. relationships, and I feel like it really is kind of the heart of a community. And one of the great tragedies of receivership is when you lose control of that heart of your community starts to erode. And so we have what I think is a super critical moment here.
We're
transferring from receivership back to local control. And in a sense, this is a chance to kind of get our community back. And I feel really strongly that we have to get it right. I put my name in
because I feel like I have a unique perspective.
I mean, obviously, I am driven intensely as a parent who's about to entrust my son for the next 13 years to the Ohio Public Schools. But I also, I work in the schools pre-receivership, in that little weird in-between period, and then when receivership was in place. So I kind of saw the trajectory of receivership. I also worked at a pretty high level when I worked at the high school, doing high school redesign with some of the upper leadership in the district, and I got to know DESE and their initiatives and their language pretty well in that time. So I feel between my experience as a student, my passion as a father, and my experience as an educator, that I'm uniquely suited to just kind of step in this role and just like start getting it done, right? Like, education can be tough. There's jargon, there's a million initiatives, there's so many acronyms, and I feel like I would do a very good job at this time when we are super critical, just kind of coming on board and like helping us right the ship. So, and I also say, fully, whether you choose me or not, and I don't think anyone here doesn't know this, but like we got to get this right, right? This is an extremely unique opportunity. Receivership was complicated. It was clearly a bad thing in the sense that, when a community loses agency for its school system, I never view that as a good thing. But there was also some really good stuff that came out of it. There was some really bad stuff that came out of it. There was stuff that came out of it that was sometimes good, sometimes bad, depending on the context. And so I just think we need to pick somebody who's ready to like step in and just kind of wrap their head around that, what is a really complex topic. So
there you go. Topic
thank you very much.
And I see Counselor Devine's
hand.
Hi, welcome, and I hope you're having a good vacation.
So far, so good, yeah.
Sí, hasta el momento, just, todo bien.
This is strictly to bring a little humor aquí, into sí que the este, equation. I'm looking at your resume,
traer algo de humor.
You have an associate's degree in psychology from Wayne Community College. You may not know this, but there's 7 women on the city council, and there's 5 women
cinco,
on the school committee.
Siete mujeres en el comité,
that you took was psychology.
Que uno de los cursos que usted tomó era psicología. Si usted nos pudiera dar un poco de perspectiva que nos pueda ayudar en esta transición.
I didn't know this was going to be impossible.
Yo no sabía que
I thought it might be tough. Sé
que iba a ser difícil.
Your guess is as good as mine there. Sorry.
Bueno, usted también puede adivinar tanto como yo.
Thank you. Figure it out. Let us know.
Pues cuando lo hayas averiguado, me dejas saber.
Counselor Graney.
Consejera Graney.
Just quickly, your attitude or your concern about the MCAS test.
De su preocupación con los MCAS.
I mean, I think.
Yo creo.
And it had been brought up in the previous conversation. It's a complex topic. Right, I don't think most people are opposed
complejo
to some sort of standard of measurement to just see
no
where students are at, particularly towards graduation time.
I think we've seen the effects of what happens
when you use that data punitively. As you had just said, that's why Hoyo lost control of its school system. I think there's a happy middle ground. MCAS as a single data point can be important. I also think that there's discussions now, and I'd be all for that, of a more robust kind of assessment system where portfolios, demonstrations, students showing that they've met the standards we want them to,
evaluaciones
and those
que
standards
puede
can be slightly different depending on the
ellos han
I mean, I think we all need
donde
the basics
quiere,
of reading and writing and math and all
todo
that,
el mundo
but
necesita los básicos
I think there's a ton of ideas
escribir,
out there about how we can do this differently.
Leer,
it's just a matter of deciding which one I think would be right for Julio.
Hay que decidir cuál sería bueno para Julio.
Thank you.
Gracias.
Dr. Rivera Colon.
Medico Rivera Colon.
So my 2 questions.
Tengo
yet
dos
again.
Preguntas otra vez.
Are you going to run for the position once the term ends?
¿Usted va a a ir para la posición una vez que termine su término, hubiera a correr. Y usted es bueno con tiempo porque tenemos muchos requisitos de cosas que tenemos que hacer. ¿Es algo que usted puede ajustar en su vida?
Again, echo what was said. Voy like I live and die by my calendar.
Por mi calendario, I'm 39 and tengo 39 años.
I don't know how people did it before
no
electronic calendars were a thing, but this is a priority.
Es una prioridad.
You know, I'm going to currently work in a position where I will have afternoons and evenings.
Tengo una posición en que voy a trabajar tarde.
This is our student, our community.
Esta es nuestra comunidad, nuestros
this is it.
Estudiantes.
So yeah, I think I will. This will be a priority, and I also, you said there's a lot of reading,
prioridad.
And I'm pretty good with that, so
y soy
I feel
bueno
like
con
I, can,
eso.
I can handle that.
Y puedo manejarlo. Consejero Rivera.
Just to be consistent, too,
solo
I guess I'll
ser
say thank you.
Consistente lo voy a decir, gracias.
And, thank you for running for public, considering public office. And then, I think we had agendas
para,
through the public school
ser
system
público.
Back
y teníamos
in those days.
Una en el pasado que se usaban.
That's what I think helped out with the calendar.
Yo creo que eso es lo que usaba, ayudaba con los calendarios.
Yeah, they used to hand those out, didn't they?
Sí, antes yeah. ellos repartían eso.
And from our student rep, Mr. Kennedy.
Y también de nuestro representante de estudiantes, señor Kennedy.
I just have one question for you. So obviously you
ti.
Are a parent,
usted
of Hawaii Public Schools, so you know, you know some of the ins and outs, but do you know,
pública,
are you up to date on like the current like budget and the financial situation and like, you know, the curriculum that is going on? Like, have you watched the school committee meetings?
Estado,
like, do you have
sido parte de los,
understanding of
the reuniones
state
del
of the
comité
district?
De escuelas.
Yeah, so I mean, I've been attending all the meetings they've had recently about the transition out of receivership.
Que han tenido
even
la
before
transición.
This was a thing, I was just really curious. Yeah, I mean, I won't pretend
no
that I've studied the budget deeply in my free time and I have some intimate knowledge of it, but
y que tengo
I do think, like, I know
íntimo.
I'm very well versed in
pero
like the funding mechanism by
en
the
el
state
mecanismo
and how they
de
do that.
Fundación, cómo se conocieron.
And I, as far as curriculum,
en términos
I mean,
de curriculum,
I'll confess to knowing a little bit more about what's going on at the upper levels because that's kind of my wheelhouse. But I'm going to get very interested in what's happening in the lower levels very soon. And I think, you know, my background in education kind of situates me nicely to just really kind of figure that out. So.
Que yo estoy en una posición muy buena para poder aprenderlo.
And hopefully your last question.
Y esperemos
as
que
the school
tu
committee continues
pregunta,
their work to exit receivership,
comité,
how will your personal and professional experience help strengthen
en términos
the work?
De salir.
Right, so I mean, and I know of all the issues that were raised tonight
yo conozco todos los temas
all the
que
time,
se han hablado hoy,
teacher retention is a big one.
Todos los problemas.
You know, I'm somebody
y
who,
retener profes maestros es un
I
problema
about,
grande.
I miss the community of the Hoya Public Schools every day, and I still chose to kind of move on. So I think when you talk about teacher retention, got some experience in that area.
Las de Hollywood,
and I also just
como
think,
quieras, me fui.
You know, the perspective has been
entonces,
for, what, 9-10 years,
la perspectiva ha sido 9-10 años,
that what's been happening in the schools
ha estado
has been
pasando
imposed.
En la escuela ha sido
and
impuesto.
Sometimes that's true, and maybe sometimes
y algunas
it's not,
es
but
cierto, y a
that's
veces
the perspective,
no es cierto.
Is we as parents, as citizens, like, it's not ours anymore,
ya
right?
No
and
es
so
nuestro.
I think in terms of my background of living here and going through the schools,
aquí,
working in the schools,
trabajando
now being a parent
escuelas,
of the schools, like I just want to be a face
escuelas,
of like, no guys, it's ours again,
escuelas,
like we can do this, we have some say,
otra vez.
Right?
Nosotros podemos,
so, you know, I just, I think I can
parte.
Do that and my goal is to
yo creo que
make it so that everybody
meta,
in Hawaii chooses to send
es que
their students to the schools because they feel like they have that ownership.
Porque
so
piensan que,
get,
ellos,
you know,
que ellos son dueños también y que podemos volver a
thank
tener en nuestras
Joe.
Manos la comunidad. No veo
questions.
Ninguna
we
más preguntas más.
You,
agradecemos tu
thank
tiempo.
All right, moving to the next resume.
Ahora,
I have Jocelyn Roby.
Pasando a la próxima resume, tengo a Jocelyn Roby.
Just make sure that green light is on.
Asegúrate que la luz verde está puesta.
Oh, not yet.
There we go. Now you can hear me.
Curriculum vitae.
So I think I said in my interest letter, I've been involved with Holyoke Public Schools since, or district-wide, since 2017.
Estoy parte de la escuela de Holyoke
2017.
Tengo un hijo que acaba de terminar. Yo empecé en Donahue, continué en el primer grado, en el segundo grado. Empecé a trabajar tiempo completo. Soy un abogado de inmobiliaria y yo quería ser parte del comité de escuelas, pero las horas que tenía no podía dar el tiempo que se necesitaba. Entonces, cuando vino esta posición y cambié mi trabajo, que estoy trabajando de casa, trabajo para compañías de seguros y trabajo con abogados inmobiliaria. Estoy trabajando con personas, con el comité de PAC, que es el comité de padres de distrito. Yo me junté con ellos en 2017 y abrió mis ojos, aparte de la sola escuela de que estaba teniendo mi escuela, la experiencia de todas las otras escuelas en Holyoke, y me dejó ver cómo iba a ser su experiencia en la escuela secundaria y era entrando en la escuela superior. Yo entiendo muy bien. Yo no estudio el presupuesto, pero hemos tenido muchos en el comité también, en las escuelas del comité que está con la escuela, construyendo la escuela nueva. Simplemente quiero ser parte, porque ser parte de DPAC, todas las reuniones, y Josh probablemente lo ha ido, cuando se juntó, y también el superintendente Soto, es lo que se oía todos los meses. ¿Cómo pueden hacer que más padres hagan parte de la escuela en Holyoke? Porque no siempre tenemos un representante de todas las escuelas, porque tenemos toda esta información y muchas de estas escuelas no están recibiendo esta información. Eso sería una de mis iniciativas al nivel del comité de escuelas o del distrito, o simplemente quieres estar al nivel del PTO, porque si los padres que están a un nivel trabajando con las escuelas de sus hijos también ayuda. Yo, como todo el mundo,
yo entiendo. Yo
no.
Children that I know, like the previous speaker just said, their neighbors. I speak with my neighbors, and they drive every day to other towns,
conducen a otros
kids to other schools,
sitios,
whether it's school choice at
si
another public school,
que han escogido otra escuela, o están pagando que sus hijos van a escuelas privadas. Y yo soy una campeona de escuelas públicas en Holyoke. Y yo hice también los estudios y enseñé a todos sus padres. Holyoke tiene mejores opciones. Mi hijo ya quiere tener ir a la escuela de HCC, porque no tienen esa oportunidad. Si se quedaran aquí, estoy muy apasionada del distrito entero, que sea un sitio mejor para todos los niños de Holyoke, con los niños que están llegando, la propia generación, los amigos de mi hijo. Si hay algunas preguntas, Consejera Greeny.
Maintain consistency. How do you feel about the MCAS test?
Consistencia. ¿Cómo te sientas sobre los exámenes de MCAS? Yo entiendo la necesidad de recobrar data. No se debería eliminar completamente. Debería haber excepciones. Algunos que tengan problemas con ansiedad, problemas de salud mental o de ADHD, o alguien con un plan individualizado de estudios, o lo deberíamos abrir más. No necesariamente que tenga un diagnóstico de un médico, de un psicólogo, o que algunas cosas que personas que tienen ansiedad con exámenes, que necesitan gente más exámenes de práctica, algún tutor, que puedan llegar a ese punto, que puedan recibir el diploma.
Miss Tensley Williams.
Miss
I'm very excited about your
Estoy muy
excitement.
Excitado.
Thank you.
And
I've always had a great concern
Siempre
about parent involvement.
Que los,
so
los
that's
padres
really one
nos
of my pet
impliquen.
Peeves. So if you can come up
si
with
es,
a way
si usted puede,
that can help us
que
to get
ayudar,
the parents involved,
que los padres
I will jump in the boat with
están
you. Because
más
my
implicados
sons graduated from Dean, and I remember
porque
going
mi hijo
to the
se graduó de
parent
Dean,
advisory committee.
Y yo fui al comité
three parents came.
Vinieron tres padres. Eso es un problema muchos años. Deben traer una manera. Y te prometo que yo no, digo, no podemos, si no hay cambio, no hay cambio. No podemos seguir haciendo las cosas de antes, mandar los boletos, por favor, venir a las reuniones de padres con maestros. Cuando estábamos en Donahue, tuviéramos una mesa para o cookies con Santa Claus, o también siempre nosotros estábamos presentes en las diferentes actividades en las escuelas, o son una de las reuniones aburridas, pero hay trabajos voluntarios, si puedes, durante el día de la escuela, o después de la escuela, o antes de la escuela.
Let's all give how we can.
Todos podemos dar como podemos dar. Yo me acuerdo ya cogiendo 600 boletos y vino más que un padre. Y eso me, de verdad me afectó. Yo sé que Zoom es una opción. Yo no quiero, pues si hay niños, gente que tiene otros niños, las oportunidades tienen una opción para guardería o dar de comer a las familias o hacerlo a través de Zoom, cualquier cosa para ayudar a las familias que participen.
Dr. Rivera Colon.
Doctor médico Colon.
Again, for the sake of consistency.
Para ser consistente. Una vez, seguiría usted, una vez de que termine su término, volver a aplicar.
You explained a little bit about this already.
Usted ya habló un poco de esto. Eso puede que su respuesta sea breve. Del tiempo, ¿cómo usted va a poder manejar el tiempo? Si me han cambiado de 8 a 100 dólares, de 8 a 100 horas a 40 horas, va a parecer como que ni tuviera un trabajo. Aún yo estaba trabajando, yo me aseguré que siempre estaba en DPAC, ese calendario, si era el tercer martes o cuarto, yo siempre lo ponía en mi calendario para que nada fuera durante esa hora. Si hay una emergencia que no pueda evitar, entonces voy a tener un seguimiento, les voy a decir que no voy a estar aquí y voy a ver lo que he faltado.
Councilor Devine.
Yes, thank you. Just a real quick question. Thank you very
Una
much for coming
pregunta
down here.
Rápida. Muchas gracias por haber venido. Bajo educación, Western New England College. ¿Qué quiere decir CLEA? Es un premio. Es una organización para escuelas legales. Escuela de derecho.
So that just means that in those two classes in law school, I had best grade in the class.
Yo tenía la mejor nota en la clase.
All right, thank you. So now it's my turn. As the school, the school committee continues their work to exit the receivership, how will your personal and professional experience help strengthen the work?
De receivership, como ustedes,
on the personal level, I've stayed involved in this.
Yo
since my son
me he quedado,
has been in kindergarten. He's now in
he estado
eighth
en
grade.
Y ahora está en octavo.
Passion to help out and
es
give
mi
back
pasión
into
de ayudar
and be that
la comunidad
for public schools.
Y ser una persona
side,
apoyando las escuelas públicas de Julio. Yo no soy una persona, no soy una persona en política o para avanzar, es simplemente porque quiero devolver a la comunidad. Como soy un abogado, estoy en muchas juntas y hacer lo de las mociones y de segundarlo. Yo ya sé cómo hacer todo eso. Quiero representar a los niños de Holyoke y quiero estar aquí.
Thank you, Jocelyn.
Muchas gracias, Jocelyn.
Appreciate your time.
Muchas gracias por tu tiempo.
Next, we have Stephen Kantrowitz. Come on in.
¿Quieres presentarte?
And then you just want to hit that button in the front. Thank you.
Hi, thank you, and thank you for the opportunity.
My name is Stephen Kantrowitz. I've been a homeowner in Holyoke since
almost Holyoke
5 years now.
5 años.
I currently teach
ahora
culinary arts with the town of South Hadley.
En South
about a year
Hadley
and a half, I taught
enseño,
at Dean from 2016
y enseño en
to
Dean
2016.
22, a 2022,
I left in November,
me fui en noviembre
with the Department of Corrections
para cocinaria.
In for a year.
Trabajé en el departamento
I was approached by
de cárceles
peers,
durante un año y me vinieron
both Hadley
distintos
and
colegas
Holyoke
de Hadley y Holyoke
who know me,
que
so
me
you
conocen,
reach out
me dijeron
and try to fill the seat.
Deberías llenar
I,
esa posición.
Have deep empathy
yo tengo
with
mucha empatía con todo lo que está pasando en Holyoke.
When I was interviewed here,
cuando me hicieron
it
la entrevista aquí, fue agosto
2016.
Right
before, this,
era un día
and
más caliente que este.
The,
y cuando fui a hablar del director,
director
y el nuevo director
said,
de CT, y
de,
dijeron en Connecticut, ¿por qué ustedes escogieron en Holyoke? Y yo les dije,
the lowest performing school in the lowest performing district in the state.
Era la escuela con
nothing's
notas más bajas en todo el estado.
And they said, you know, can you start Monday?
Y me dijeron, usted puede empezar el lunes.
Grabbing the bull by the horns.
Entonces cogiendo el toro por los cuernos que teníamos en Dean. Fue un sitio muy excitante para trabajar y me encantó ahí.
As a result, receivership,
entonces,
admin,
por la quiebra,
leadership, my,
y admin,
it was time
direct.
For me to go. I had a lot of disagreements
era
with
tiempo
the,
porque tuve muchos desacuerdos
the powers that be at the school at that time.
Con los que
but
eran jefes en ese momento, pero nunca me fui de
Holyoke.
Muchos de mis estudiantes, yo hablo con ellos.
Friends are still in touch.
Todavía mis colegas de antes
I
estamos.
Think one of the strengths I have
también.
With this position is I don't have ties.
Esta posición
children-wise and student-wise
no,
to the town.
No
I think I could really look
tengo,
at this as an educator.
Yo pudiera verlo como un educador
education. And,
intentando no afectar la educación
DESI,
porque no tengo niños implicados
from,
en el sistema.
2023,
en 2023
really make
a no ser
big
que
differences
hagamos
in
cambios grandes en retener
and
los maestros
absenteeism.
Y también ausentes crónicos, nada va a cambiar.
Was,
eso tiene que ser el enfoque.
Sorry, forget your name.
No me acuerdo
Wilson,
tu nombre,
Nelson.
Okay.
At the last meeting, you
en el último momento
wholeheartedly
usted dijo
with, and I think that should be a major
que eso tiene que ser muy importante, la necesidad
to build remote aspect and to
de
learning
crear un aspecto remoto
kids aren't in school,
para aprendizaje. Si los niños no están en la escuela, no están
DESI
aprendiendo.
The ball hard when
y
we came DESI back and they said, remote's over.
Le dijeron
really,
que ya se ha terminado
really
la escuela remoto cuando dejamos eso.
A major focus
y eso tiene que ser un
enfoque
para que estemos al día con la tecnología y lo que está pasando en la educación. Consejero
yes,
Graney,
from a vocational educator's perspective,
una perspectiva de un educador, ¿qué son tus sentimientos sobre los MCAS?
Yo
veo,
pues
ya,
MCAS
sería eliminado
right
ahora mismo
it's
si fuera para mí.
Test.
Es un
amount, and I see this from teachers, the amount of
examen
time
estándar,
that
el tiempo que ellos toman, ese tiempo
teaching,
que les quita a los
it,
maestros.
It does a disservice to every facet, the students,
eso
teachers,
le quita
the parents,
a los padres, los coleccionadores
so
de data,
schools,
tanto que hay que aprender los maestros, los niños,
and
es simplemente superfluo.
MCAS,
para que sea una condición
is,
de graduarse,
I think just unjust.
Yo creo que es injusto.
Thank you.
Dr. Rivera Colon.
Dr. Rivera Colon.
My two questions.
Mis dos preguntas.
So, should you be appointed,
si
would you run
fueran,
for the next term?
Si te fueran a dar la posición, ¿quisieras a seguir al segundo término?
Yes,
quisiera decir que sí, definitivamente, pero
all,
si yo no lo puedo dar 100%, entonces lo pasaré. No voy a hacer
I
las cosas a mitad.
South Hadley,
enseño
teach
en South Hadley, en también escuela, una, también trabajo en el Boys and Girls Club y trabajo también en una clase en inglés como segunda lengua.
I try to do two things at 100,
no hago las cosas a 80%. 90% lo hago a 100.
Pero yo te voy a decir
la razón que ustedes quieren oír. Eso no es justo. Si funciona bien, lo haría. Pero lo vamos a tomar un paso a paso. Y ahora la segunda pregunta que usted ya ha dicho.
It is a big time commitment.
Es, requiere mucho tiempo. ¿Usted piensa que podría lo que pide? Vamos a ver qué tal va este año y medio. Yo estoy solo.
Don't like time off.
No me gusta
my
tener tiempo libre.
Friday.
Mi último día de escuela fue viernes. Ahora ya estoy molesto y necesito algo que hacer. Mi punto es, si lo hago, lo hago 100%.
From our student rep, Mr. Kennedy.
De nuestro representante escolar, señor Kennedy.
I know how strong of an advocate you are. You were one of my teachers.
Yo
so
sé, usted era uno de mis maestros.
Currently up to date. I know that you were an HPS teacher.
Al día,
not
yo
too
sé
long ago,
que era un maestro de SPS. ¿Cómo está funcionando el distrito en todo lo que está pasando? Y mencioné el presupuesto.
My only experience with the budget.
Presupuesto. Lo único que yo sé del presupuesto es lo que mi experiencia en Dean. Y es una de las razones que me fui.
Came from the whole one school, three campus.
Una escuela. Campus gratis de fiasco.
Presently no budget.
Y ahora no hay presupuesto. No sé cómo está funcionando el presupuesto en este momento. Lo que oigo de mis colegas, no hablan del presupuesto. Hablan de
admin, leadership,
de
micromanaging,
de
letting us
manejar, manejar el tiempo.
I think every school should be
directores de administración. Yo creo que todas las escuelas deberían ser un castillo en la colina, pero maestros en general aprendan a trabajar con menos. Eso no quiere decir que te vas a morir de hambre, pero la gente, el dinero no compra éxito. Pero si está hecho bien y los maestros de verdad se entregan, se puede haber éxito. Yo sería también una persona que apoyaría mucho a los maestros, porque ellos son los que cuidan los maestros. No puedes tener los estudiantes primero y no los maestros segundos, porque son los maestros que tienen las botas en el piso y ellos necesitan nuestro apoyo. Para cuando ellos continúan para salir de la quiebra, ¿cómo ustedes va a salir adelante? Pues yo camino el camino. Yo trabajo con gente joven en el Boys, el club de niños y niñas, estudiantes de inglés como segunda lengua en la Universidad de Holyoke. Estoy completamente entregado. Tienes que pensar un poco diferente. No tienes que pensar pues con dinero de regalarles $1,000. Y tengo una debilidad, yo digo lo que pienso. Y tengo, y también es un punto fuerte decir lo que yo pienso. Yo tenía ideas muy buenas. Que me decían, no podemos hacer eso. Tenemos que seguir adelante. Pero no tengo miedo
moving forward.
Desde hacer lo necesario y decir lo que pienso para seguir adelante. Muchas gracias. No veo más preguntas. Muchas gracias. Gracias por tu tiempo.
All right.
Okay.
We have two more resumes in front of me. Up next is Devin Sheehan.
Curriculum vitae is Devin Sheehan.
And I'll let you take it away.
Y dejaré que usted empiece. Muchas gracias.
First of all, thank
Primero,
you all
muchas
for
gracias
out
por haber venido
this
esta noche.
Very hot night, but it's, I think, subarctic
calor,
in here right
pero
now.
Aquí está así chambers, como...
so, my name is Devin Sheehan. I'm a lifelong resident of Hoyle, currently living on Ontario Avenue. With my partner,
Avenida,
foster child. I say foster child, but I really should be saying that he's a 21-year-old attending Westfield State as a senior, not really a child, and he's been with
State
us for many years now.
Y lleva muchos años con
I have
nosotros.
Previous experience serving on the school committee,
Tengo muchos
and
años
my first time serving on the school
de escuelas,
committee was actually as a sophomore in high school, as the student representative, so it goes
en el segundo
all the
way back
many years, so I don't really want to count at this
point.
So I worked
no
for the Springfield Public Schools
Trabajo
for 11 years,
para la escuela pública de Springfield 11 años en la escuela de Financia Procuria y soy aquí también un oficial para de procuramiento
for the 25,000 student school
y también
district.
Para las, el
My
distrito
current role,
de
I serve as the
estudiantes.
Chief of Staff to State Senator
Ahora,
Jake Oliveira.
Estoy para
I previously served as the President of the Massachusetts Association of School Committees and in the community, been a member of the Children's Museum Board, the Hoyle Parade Committee, and I serve on the Distribution Committee for the Community Foundation of Western Massachusetts.
I'm also
In the past, on the school committee,
I
was proud to be a member when we introduced our dual language programs and our full day preschool here in the district. That's just
bilingües.
Two programs that have both grown
Dos programas que
and
han
helped families
y han ayudado familias inmensamente.
Especially, I mean, dual language
especialmente
is superb,
las clases
but Holyoke
bilingües
was one of the first
estupendo. Y
that was offering
fue uno de los
full day preschool.
Que
and to be able to offer that to families and to start learning early.
Y
but to also
pronto.
Partner
también,
with our community partners through VOC, YMCA,
Square
One, Head Start, to make sure
one,
the families were fully served.
Y aseguranos que todas las familias que podamos estar muy orgullosos como una comunidad.
I find myself pursuing this position to serve the greater Holyoke community.
Esta posición,
all too often in Holyoke,
muchas veces en Holyoke
and within public education,
y en educación pública,
we find families
nos
that
familias
find themselves
que
not heard with our public
que,
schools.
No
and I'm here to help be
oída.
A voice for some of those
Yo
families,
una voz para
the parents
familias,
who are struggling to get
que,
phone calls back,
que
are
no
trying to work through IEP
atrás,
meetings, or just came to our area and trying to navigate how to enroll their students. I'm ready to help them with some of those challenges.
Y yo estoy aquí
we also need to
ayudarlos.
Talk about our workforce.
Tengo,
our school committee can be a driving force in developing
Nuestro
our workforce.
De escuelas puede
we
ser.
Have a treasure that is
tenemos
Dean Technical High School.
Un
tesoro
de Dean que ha visto
huge opportunities over
muchas
the past
oportunidades en muchos años.
Close to 50 students that
más
were in co-ops this past year.
Más de 50 estudiantes que estaban en cooperativas. Estamos viendo estudiantes graduando
vocational certificates
con sus
so they can go and start working.
Para que puedan empezar a trabajar.
Business owners in our community
que los dueños
are saying,
de los negocios que necesitamos.
Tomorrow if
vamos
you can
a contratar
to
personas
and
mañana si me los puedes mandar.
But we also need to think differently with it. We see other communities in our area offering
Vemos
their Chapter 74 programs in the evening and offering other options
tarde,
for students who don't choose to attend vocational
no
education for a full school day but want different
regular,
opportunities to attend that and we need to expand that
on
those areas.
Zonas.
We also as a district need
También
to look inward to our workforce.
Adentro.
We need to focus in on grow your own programs. We have people that are entering the workforce in our schools as paraprofessionals,
como para profesionales,
as educators, with bachelor's degrees that are looking for that next step. We should be bridging and helping
paso.
Our parapropressionals to become
deberíamos
teachers
estar
if they choose to build those areas. We should be encouraging
deberíamos
our educators
dejar...
to become administrators within our buildings and administrators within
y
our system because that way we will help retain and our talent. We're providing more of those educational opportunities.
We
have helped many teachers to earn their master's degree. Some have left and some have stayed. They can see a commitment in the Hoyle Public Schools and
Sí, ellos ven un compromiso que nosotros estamos comprometidos con ellos para que se queden así, nosotros podemos conseguir que ellos se queden y escucharlos. Y más importante, mientras nosotros vemos a través de ese plan de transición de control sobre el Estado para controlar localmente,
We need to make
Nosotros
sure that all voices are heard in this. I've had the opportunity to attend in person and watch almost all the meetings that the school committee has had regarding the transition. And we need to ensure that student voices are heard, educator voices are heard, and the community has a say in that transition. Because the state can say, here you go, your schools are back. But until we have a committed community and full school community that are ready for our schools to be back within the Hoyoke Public Schools and within the state of Hoyoke, we're going to see our ourselves right where we were. So we need to make sure that all of those voices are being heard and all of those stakeholders are being engaged with that process. I just want to thank you all again for taking the time tonight. I know that you all have busy schedules, and I really appreciate everything that all of you do. Madam President, Madam Vice Chair.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
It's great to say both Madam President and Vice Chair.
Isn't it really?
So, Councillor Graney, and then Councillor DeMille.
Councillor Graney, and then Councillor DeMille. Así que rápido, solamente en la reunión. Para mantener la consistencia, estaba interesado para saber que estás en favor de contratar dentro en el sistema de la escuela. Eso sería algo muy refrescante. Pero ¿cómo te sientes sobre el MCAS?
So,
así que
I think that question yo creo que esa pregunta es, the MCAS, el MCAS an assessment tiene un assessment que puede ver dónde está el estudiante y cómo lo educador I think is appropriate, just like many of the other assessments, both educator created and third party created that educators use. The fact that we are penalizing students to not graduate because they don't pass one test, our public schools have high quality, rigorous instruction that follows the pacing set forward by the Massachusetts Department of Elementary and Secondary Education of what they're supposed to meet. We also hire high quality, trained, licensed educators, many of whom have at least master's degrees or higher degrees. And we tell them, you know what, teach these students for 13 years, assess them all along the way, but right when they get to graduation, it's not up to them if they graduate. No tiene que ver con ellos, sino los profesionales que nosotros estamos poniendo en el edificio no ni siquiera pueden hacer esa decisión para asegurarse de que nuestros estudiantes están trabajando en colegios y forma de trabajo. El hecho de que nosotros estamos llevando a un estudiante que llegue a nuestro distrito porque nosotros lo vemos todos los días en Holyoke y otras comunidades urbanas y digan, ok, bienvenido a Holyoke, nosotros entendemos que solamente veniste aquí y no hablan ni siquiera inglés. Pero siéntate aquí y tomaste ese examen. Si no pasas ese examen, tienes que tomar tres veces más. Si no lo pasas, entonces no puedes graduar. Eso está mal. Nosotros estamos creando igualdad en comunidades de color, en poblaciones de especial con nuestros The dropout rate isn't getting worse because students are passing the test. The dropout rate is getting worse because we have students that don't want to take the test, that don't want to come to school, because they see themselves doing okay in school, and then they're told, you're a failure, here's a certificate of completion. So the fact that we have a high-stakes graduation requirement is wrong. The fact that we have a measure of student performance that educators can use to provide supports to students, to be able to look at and provide supports for communities, that's okay, because that's another tool for all of our highly qualified licensed educators.
Todos nuestros educadores calificados.
Councillor Devine.
Yes, hi, thank you, Devin, for coming down here.
Por venir aquí y hablar en la experiencia. Una de las cosas que yo estoy interesado es que probablemente saber, alguna persona sabe.
And what I see here in your resume, you served on the negotiation team for ratification of nine collective bargaining agreements, and I'm not positive, but
no
when the
positivo,
schools went into receivership,
cuando la escuela va en recibimiento,
so when the schools went into receivership, all of those rights were taken from the school committee and given to that of the receiver. So the main person bargaining was technically the receiver, and that could be delegated out to other individuals. But prior to receivership, the school committee is actually the employer of record. So I think whereas like with the city, the mayor leads those negotiations with the different collective bargaining units of the city. On the school committee, the school committee are the ones leading the collective bargaining efforts. So the school committee is at the bargaining table doing that and working with those unions and making sure that agreements are made on both sides. I mean, it's a contract, so sometimes you can't have everyone winning, but you can hopefully get to a middle ground where everyone can at least walk away being happy, and it's a fair and balanced contract and it works with the budget and the student
needs.
Ms. Tensley Williams?
Senator Tensley Williams?
Devin, just to be on the one side, Are you willing to run for president?
Así que vas a correr por presidente.
For president? Are you willing to run for president of the United States?
Así que quieres correr como presidente de Estados Unidos?
Rosalie, that's a question Rosalie, for another day.
Dr. Rivera Colón.
Okay, señor Rivera Colón.
Again, two questions.
Dos preguntas.
Would you be willing to run for the next term? Should you be
para
appointed?
Término?
Yes.
Sí.
Yes.
And then,
¿y?
How about time management? Would you be able to prioritize and have the time
¿cómo,
to serve?
¿Cómo puede proyectar
yeah, absolutely. I wouldn't have submitted my name if I
no
wasn't ready for that, and I really took into a lot of consideration, spoke to my family, spoke to my employer, went through all of that, and knowing all of the requirements of the job, and to really put in 100% into it, because that's what, I mean, that's what public service
is, 100%, because you can't miss a meeting, you can't do the same thing, you can't do the same thing, so absolutely, I'm ready for that. Yo estoy listo para eso.
I'll be the last question.
Seré la última pregunta.
So as the school committee continues their work to exit receivership,
saliendo,
how will your personal and professional experience help strengthen the work?
So I think first and foremost, I think I'm going to talk about my role as being a communicator and I think bring people together. I touched upon earlier that we need to make sure that all of our stakeholders are engaged. And I know that I'm not going to be able to do that myself. So I think leaning on community partners and making sure that community partners understand the transition plan of the Hoyoke Public Schools and the Hoyoke School Committee with the state so they can engage with members of the community. I think working with, I mean, it was great just to see the other day that I think Hoyoke had 25 new translators that were certified as licensed translators graduate. So I think engaging the licensed translators, engaging our parent and community staff of public schools have worked with them. I also think my ability and knowledge just of being able to review our policies and see where we're going. I mean, this is such a interesting aspect when you think of how government works for the Hoyoke School Committee of Hoyoke Public Schools. We get to really take a deep dive in our policies in which many boards don't that often and say, is this working right now for the Hoyoke School Committee? Is this going to work for the future? And if not, let's change it. And I think that going through our policies, and I know that there's a committee already working on that, and I know that's going on, but really focusing on that and saying, what is going to work for the next 10 years? Are we nimble enough to be able to get the job done? And I also think my background in school finance and in educator development is only going to help some of that with the committee, with the school community, and the city as a whole.
All righty.
Okay.
Thank you Gracias. Very much, Devin.
Mucho, Devin.
Appreciate your time.
Aprecio tu tiempo.
And if you are the public, you, si, not you. But if folks are tuning in at home
si
and you're like,
casa,
this doesn't seem
no
like a city council meeting, it's a city council and school committee meeting right now. So just in case someone's
si
tuning in from home.
Está aquí en casa.
And the last resume that I have
última,
here is Raúl Gutiérrez.
El último horario que
Come
tengo aquí,
in.
Raúl Gutiérrez, venga.
And then just make sure that green light is
on.
It's on.
Okay.
Yes.
So, thank you and
así que gracias.
Good afternoon.
Y buenas tardes a todo el mundo.
So, my name is Raúl Gutiérrez.
Mi nombre es Raúl Gutiérrez.
I'm a professor
Yo soy profesor
at the Community
College.
I also have collaborated
y también he colaborado
with,
con
different
diferentes
administradores and the high school specifically in the middle school regarding the dual language
school,
program.
En cuanto al programa de dual language,
building it as they're walking, so my son is the first, the only and for class to graduate from Mecca.
Y la única persona que se ha graduado ahí. So we're building, así que estamos trabajando y creando espacios para ellos que puedan recibir crédito de la universidad para cursos de España. De español y he trabajado y colaborando con mi experiencia como un educador por 23 años, los dos para niveles de colegio. He trabajado en FNC por 10 años y yo creo también tengo experiencia en cuanto a como padre, como mi and also creating a como tiene dificultad de mis hijos y ayudándolo, y también estamos en el historial de del historial y todo que hemos hecho en el pasado. Yo creo que lo que nosotros necesitamos enfocado es como un comité de la escuela, que si me dijeron en cuanto a entendiendo que nuestros estudiantes
full human beings,
son humanos
regarding en cuanto how their lives are going
cómo su vida va por encima de la escuela, porque es muy fácil decir que nuestros estudiantes son ineficientes en ese efecto, pero nosotros también tenemos que entender que hay otras cosas que están lidiando a cómo nosotros en nuestra vida. Segundo, yo creo que para retención de los estudiantes, especialmente high achieving teachers, y eso es algo que nosotros necesitamos como hacer una estrategia, como crear mejores oportunidades.
Safe, like better opportunities and better
environments. Mejor oportunidad y mejores ambiente para los
but I think that maestros que with my experience,
sigan. Así que con mi experiencia,
solamente para que se aseguren
si quieren hacer esto, ¿no? Yo también hablé con mi adolescente y dije, ¿por qué no? Y también sería una buena idea. Así que yo dije, bueno, también voy a poner mi gorra. Yo estoy muy impresionado con los chicos que están acá, así que yo aprecio ellos que me permitan estar acá. Y gracias. Gracias.
Councilor
Graney, primero.
Quickly, sir, once
rápido,
again,
de nuevo.
What are your feelings about the MCAS?
¿Cuáles son tus sentimientos sobre el MCAS? Yo estoy de acuerdo con la mayoría de las personas que yo creo que el MCAS es un punto de data, pero una vez en cuanto a cómo nuestros estudiantes son humanos, yo creo que nosotros deberíamos, algunos de nosotros, ya bien, otros no. Yo creo que nosotros tenemos que entender cuál es la cantidad y la calidad de cómo los estudiantes ven las cosas. Así que yo confío en los maestros que están trabajando con mis estudiantes para otra vez tener un buen material para eso. Y para que ellos asistan a mis hijos y mi hijo que estén haciendo bien. Así que yo creo que eso está mal para nosotros esperar que los graduados pasen un examen y si no lo pasan, no se pueden graduar.
Dr. Caballero Roca.
Ok, Caballero Roca.
Good afternoon, Raúl, and
it's good
to see you. Thank you so much.
Así que gracias.
You had in. You mentioned something.
Así que mencionaste algo que realmente resuena conmigo.
The life of the students beyond school.
Para que
expand on that.
Que puedes expandir en eso. I think that los chicos en la escuela, yo creo que nosotros entendemos que hay.
That's an issue. I teach at a community college, and we see similar issues regarding.
Para otros situaciones.
From Holyoke, Chicopee, and Springfield. I think that there is house insecurity, food insecurity, that are like affecting our students' lives. And understanding that, if students are hungry, they're gonna try like they're not gonna be able to do well.
So like, there is all these other things that they're doing.
I am working with the students in
the community empowering lab. De empoderamiento.
Just a shout out, they're doing a youth conference on the 28th. So it is speaking to them and allowing them to
con
ellos permitiéndolo
que respondan y con problemas que están lidiando
fuera
de las clases.
And as an educator, you
y como educador tiene que entender que esto no solamente la persona que está sentando delante de ti, la persona que vive afuera de las
It's kind of unfair to not understand the student as a whole.
Como que no es justo. Así que yo creo que está.
Regarding understanding that the student might not be able to pay attention.
Puede que el estudiante no está prestando atención o puede estar lidiando con alguna casa y siempre mi acercamiento preguntando si está bien o diciendo qué es lo que está pasando, que si todo está bien y luego ella me dice. Así que yo creo. Yo creo que nosotros tenemos que entender que muchos de nuestros estudiantes del sistema de pobre de Holyoke tienen con muchas cosas que están por encima del control de los estudiantes y no es el rol de los estudiantes de resolver todo el problema, pero es el rol de ellos estar consciente de lo que está pasando y siendo teniendo apatía sobre lo que está pasando, empatía. Señora Williams,
it's nice to have you here.
Es bueno tenerte acá.
When I was a mentor,
cuando yo era mentor Marines, para los marinos en Holyoke,
what I did
lo que yo hice fue que yo tuve permiso porque algunos de los niños no podían escribir y muchos de ellos eran hispanos, así que conseguí permiso de los líderes de que si pueden hacer las preguntas si estarían de bueno que lo que yo escribo, porque muchos de los niños solamente no sabían cómo escribir, mucha gente no te puede tomar el examen. Mencioné el examen y ellos solamente se asustan muchas veces. Ellos sí saben los resultados. Yo dije, por favor, si ellos me pueden dar la respuesta a la pregunta que yo le estoy haciendo, que si está bien, si yo lo escribo y luego yo solamente la voy a poner a iniciar y ellos me dieron permiso y muchos de los chicos hicieron eso. Yo creo que tomando en cuenta de que educación siempre está enseñando la habilidad de entender la información que estás consumiendo. Entonces hay ese movimiento que se mueve del tema de los exámenes que dice que no pruebe nada por encima de lo que puedas probar, de lo que puedas aprender así, en el mundo real. Esto funcionaría. Gracias por venir.
Rivera
Colón.
I bet you can guess what I'm going to
ask. Yo creo que sabes lo que yo voy a preguntar.
Yes.
Sí.
So, should entonces, you be appointed, would you si run for the position?
Si te apuntan si te nominan, puedes correr con la posición y qué tal el tiempo
for everything that's required
para todo
for
lo que se pide por la posición.
I think that,
así que yo creo que
being in grad school have taught me to
siendo manage a lot of things. Un profesor me ha ayudado a manejar muchas cosas. Yo creo que yo estoy muy bueno manejando mi tiempo.
To be honest,
y para serte sincero,
applied or sent my
yo no hubiera aplicado ni si enviara mi matrícula, porque yo creo que yo estoy apasionado no solamente por mis hijos estando en el sistema de la escuela y también para los niños de la ciudad. Yo creo que esos chicos que van a tomar y nosotros tenemos que asegurarnos de que ellos están listos y siendo apoyados.
Final question of the
así que no tengo pregunta.
When I find it.
Cuando la encuentre.
Oh God, I had it. As the school committee continues to work to exit leadership, how will your personal and professional
experiencia personal y profesional va a ayudar?
I think that
yo creo que primero yo soy bilingüe y yo soy fluente en español y también es importante como una ayuda especialmente en esta ciudad.
Yo también I allow the voices of the youth.
Yo permito las voces de los jóvenes.
So I think that having this contact,
yo creo que teniendo este contacto con estos jóvenes y sabiendo
their own school system into something
y sabiendo
better,
que
in the future. Also I think that
y sabiendo que
I am really hard working.
Yo soy un trabajador muy duro.
Incredibly like committed to this work because I think I work in a community college which is the most democratic access to higher
lo cual
education.
Es la más
so I think that having folks
y teniendo
and
chicos
a lot of the students that
y muchos estudiantes que vienen de HBS que no son
and
HBC,
I see the potential and
yo
I
veo
see
el potencial
I think that like my passion
y yo creo
for the
que
work
mi pasión para el trabajo
is going to be there
y va a estar ahí.
Thank you very much.
Gracias.
We appreciate your time.
Apreciamos tu tiempo.
I just want to say thank you so much
así que yo solamente quiero decir gracias
the individuals who submitted
para
los
individuos que se me hicieron sus
it was very heartwarming to
nombre.
See so many people were interested for this position, so thank you again.
Así que gracias.
And just
Before we go into the next part, I just want to double check that no one else in this room.
Nadie más en esta habitación está aquí para someter su número, su nombre, mm-hmm. o en línea.
Or online. You have the chance to, so, all right.
I'm going to go to the first ballot.
All right, there's a motion been made and seconded.
Y segundada.
Oh, I'm sorry, go ahead.
Mr. Kennedy?
No, I just have a question
Así
for
tengo una pregunta
Madam
para
President or Madam Vice
la persona.
Chair. I do not have a vote
yo no tengo un voto
at this table.
En esta mesa para que yo.
Yo estaba en este comité
esta
año.
Yo solamente quería saber si yo podía poner mi mi recomendación o alguien que yo me gustaría hacer una moción que nosotros permitamos. Moción se ha hecho y segundada. Debajo segunda. Así que me voy a estar en el comité antes por tres años. Y hay dos candidatos aquí. Personalmente, yo estaba muy impresionado. Yo creo que todos los candidatos.
One specific candidate
Pero
that
fue
stuck
un
out
candidato
to me
que
right
sobresalió muy rápido porque él
he's proven to be a very good
ha probado ser muy abogado
por
estudiantes aquí
as well
en ese distrito
y
ha tenido la experiencia necesariamente
so
para. Así que si yo tuviera este voto en una mesa ahora mismo y de nuevo, no hay un candidato. Bueno, de nuevo, así yo hubiera cancelado mi voto por Kyle Chambers. Yo he visto a él constantemente abogando. Por maestro, yo creo que sería una muy buena decisión.
Thank you, and thank you for being
gracias,
here.
Y gracias por estar acá.
All right. Okay. So, there was another motion made
okay,
and seconded
otra moción,
for the
segunda,
first ballot.
Por el primer,
so with that, the clerk will call
eso,
the roll and remember, whoever gets
así
to
que, quien sea
12,
que consiga 12
votes first will be
van
the appointed
a apuntados.
Representative.
Y como representativos.
Anderson Burgos.
Anderson Burgos.
Devin Sheehan.
Devin Sheer.
Bartley.
Bartley. Devin Sheer.
Divine.
Divine.
Givner.
Givner.
Devin Sheehan.
Devin Sheer.
Rainey.
Sheehan.
Rainey.
Mr. Sheehan.
Mr. Sheehan. Jordan. Devin Sheer.
McGrath Smith.
McGrath Smith.
Devin Sheehan.
Devin Sheer.
Murphy Rumbeletti.
Murphy Rumbeletti.
Sheehan.
Sheehan.
Ocasio.
Ocasio. Sheehan.
Israel Rivera.
Israel Rivera.
Devin Sheehan.
Devin Sheehan.
Jenny Rivera.
Jenny Rivera.
Devin Sheehan.
Devin Sheehan.
Sullivan.
Sullivan.
Devin Sheehan.
Devin Sheehan.
Bacon.
Bacon.
Kyle Chambers.
Carballo Rocco.
Carballo Rocco.
Raul Gutierrez.
What was it? Can you repeat that, please?
Raul Gutierrez.
Raul Gutierrez.
Collimore.
Collimore.
Garcia.
Garcia.
Devin Sheehan.
Devin Sheehan.
Lefebvre.
Lefebvre.
Devin Sheehan.
Devin Sheehan.
Rivera Colon.
Rivera Colon.
Devin Sheehan.
Devin Sheehan.
Romero.
Romero.
Devin Sheehan.
Devin
Sheehan.
Tinsley
Williams.
Tinsley Williams.
Devin Sheehan.
Willihan.
Willihan.
Wilson.
Wilson.
Mr. Devin Sheehan.
Señor Devin Sheehan.
Devin Sheehan appointed on the first ballot.
Devin Sheehan apuntado en el primer ballot.
All right. Thank you, everyone. And thank you again.
Y gracias de nuevo.
And thank you all very, very seriously, every single person who put their name in. Thank you
todos,
for doing that. Please keep doing that.
Así
can
que,
I just make one brief comment?
Yeah.
Estamos listos para terminar.
I think we were
sí,
blessed to have
yo,
a
que yo
wonderful
estoy
group
bendecido de tener
and
un,
I would just like to encourage
bastante,
candidato,
así que yo quiero decir que a cada uno que corra por el comité de la escuela para la próxima elección. Es muy importante por la salud de nuestra comunidad. Competición en nuestro
mayor
o alcalde.
That's right.
But
run
for it all,
sí,
please.
Run
for it all. All right. So the motion was made and seconded to adjourn.
Se ha hecho,
all those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? We'll take a 5-minute break. And then we'll be back. So 5 minutes.
Así que en 5 minutos.
Thank you, everyone.
Gracias a todo el mundo. 7:30.